So hi, Lynn Hoggeist from Kinlochleven High School, and I'm Joan, the managing director. Have you ever been in that situation, say in the office or staffing, where you just cannot remember whose tea or coffee is whose? Hoggeist designs and manufactures hand-painted and personalised mugs, which are especially great for these common situations. Each mug comes with a checklist of tea, coffee, milk and sugar, and they each come with a whiteboard pen to write down orders. We are also a very health conscious company, and so we've included a card which will inform consumers of the maximum recommended caffeine intake per day in terms of cups of tea and coffee.
I'm Hannah, the production manager. Our most unique design solves the problem in seconds or at home when there's always someone who doesn't get what they ask for. We post the designs made by our production team on Facebook, and we also take requests. Once the mug has been made for the customer, we bake them in the oven. This helps the paints to set. However, the mugs are not dishwasher friendly, and we do mention that on the card. A new design we would like to introduce is microwavable mugs. They come with a recipe card like this one here, which you can make quick puddings or tasty snacks.
Hi, I'm Marianne, the marketing manager. To promote our business, we use social media account like Facebook, which currently has 150 likes. This is targeted a wide audience and has been very successful, as many orders have been flooded. At the moment, we have a special promotion, as it is coming up to Christmas, and we have our Christmas plates. When Christmas ends, we'll be entering other markets, like the Easter market and the Valentine's. We'll be attending the trade fair in Inverness, as well as other local fairs in our area. We did desk research to see what prices to set as well, and also kept prices competitive to others on the market.
Hi, I'm Emma, I'm a finance manager. So to begin with, we've got 36 mugs, and each mug costs £2.72 to produce. We then sell a standard design mug for £5.99 and £6.99 for a personalised mug. That will give us £3.27 profit for unpersonalised and £4.27 for personalised. We bought 20 plates to begin with, and they cost £1.40 to produce. We then sell them for £7.99, which gives us a £6.59 profit. If we sell everything unpersonalised, we'll get £375. Everything personalised, we'll get £411. We currently have 28 orders, which will give us a £211 in sales and £147 in profit.
We would like to ask you for £100 in order for us to expand our business by purchasing more plates for the Christmas designs, more paints for decorating the mugs and plates, and microwave mugs so we can expand into making microwave mug cakes. Is there any questions?
Thank you very much. Without sounding a bit thick, I'm not quite understanding. So, I'm making a cup of tea for a group of people and memory of goldfish. So, and then I'm going to mark this up with each one and then that just wipes off.
Yes, you can test if you like.
Okay, I'll do that in a moment.
Okay.
So, this is similar to Starbucks and Costa. I have a Costa coffee concession on my businesses. And they for a while had a thing on the top of the lid that you push down. There were little bubbly bits and you push them down. But they stopped doing them. My concern with this is this only useful where there's a huge order? So if this is, in a household or something like this, you're not really going to need it, there's only two or three.
So we have that, but on many other mugs, it's just plain on the back and you can have your name on that.
So you just personalise it that way?
Yeah, so whatever the customer would like, we can basically do.
Fine. And the Santa and Rudolph plate, I just like that. I like the sort of little humour in that, and I think that's a fantastic product. Fine, I shall.
I love the plate. Play is outstanding, I have to say. I've got a couple of young kids and they would just love that. I've never seen that before actually, even in any of the shops. Is it? Have you done some market research on that one?
Yeah, we did some market research and we found that on Google, we found similar designs to that, but we kind of amalgamated them and made them kind of personalised to what we wanted.
Yeah, it's really good. I quite like the, what is it, the custom sort of coffee thing you do. But the only thing you could do, if you went into, you mentioned the staff room earlier on, if you went to schools or businesses and actually sold them a lot, you might actually do well with that, to have a personalised mug. Because it's quite quirky, you know, and it's quite nice to see it.
Yeah, so we actually have started selling some to small businesses in the area. So not anything set in stone yet.
I also noticed you sold 28 mugs, the non-personalised ones, is that correct? That's what I heard. The personalised ones?
Some of them are personalised, some of them are.
Okay, so £180 in orders, which in my last presentation I said take 50% up front. Have you managed to secure that money? No. Just go back to them. Try and go back to them and say, give me your money.
These are just orders.
Yeah, no, absolutely. No. We do that as business folk. And we get money up front, give us the money, and then you know what it does? A, it gives you cash flow in order to reinvest and buy some materials. But also, it actually secures the purchase because they probably will not want to forfeit the money. They probably will go ahead with the other 50%. Whereas when it's just orders from someone you vaguely know, they might not have any money when you come to delivering the product to them. Because it's quite a lot of money you've got. That well done, by the way. 20 orders. I mean, you have to commend yourself for that.
Yeah, well done. I think your graphics are very good. I like your design, it's very bold and it's good, particularly on the plate. I'm going to say, if you're going to sell mugs to offices, which are going to be used and reused and reused, the lack of dishwasher is durability is a potential problem. Have you tried and worked out how many times you can actually just wash them up normally? Does that, is just hand washing got a good life?
So we didn't do it for a long period of time, but some of our team members really scrubbed them and depended on them often.
Right. So what does the dishwasher do?
I guess it's probably just the...
Have you tried? Have you put it in the dishwasher just to see what the effect would be?
Yes.
And it disappeared, did it? It disappeared.
Yes, it disappeared.
Right. Okay.
So, that is good that you've got 28 orders, and you were saying that you sold all the non-personalised, it'll be 375, all the personalised 411. You're in quite a good position now where you've actually got some data that you can decide on the split, so I would take your 28 orders, see what split that is, it's 50-50, and then make your projections on your, whatever that distribution is, it'll just make them more accurate. Projections, because projections can be difficult, but you've already got data, so that puts you in a good position. I like the products. I think if you're going to be doing staff rooms and that kind of stuff, you could offer them in packs, like a six pack of cups, and if you're off, you can have a couple of different price brackets, if they're a custom or not. If it was a school, you can have the school level one, or if it's like a football team that a teacher likes, you put that on his mug or whatever, but I think it's good product. I would like to sell more.
Thank you very much indeed.